it's a long-standing debate in glycobiology field and in cancer glycobiology whether the changes in glycosylation are a cause or a consequence of the cancer process. We have evidence supporting that changes in glycosylation can consequently result in cancer development, but we also have evidences that changes in glycosylation can be a consequence of a transformed phenotype. So we have both evidences supporting both events.